And hello YouTube, this is GSmaniamsmart, and I'm going to have another brand new video for tutorials with GS. In today's tutorial, we're teaching you how to use virtual desktops in Windows 10 and how they can be very useful, and you can take advantage of this to make your workspace a bit more organized and to not have so many windows open. Now, a lot of times what will happen is that you'll end up having so many windows open that if you go to the if you press Alt Tab, or if you press this button at the bottom here, this is a new button here that actually shows you all of your tabs open. Sometimes you'll have a lot of windows open, and sometimes if you want to like browse between different windows, you have so many of these open, you have to like constantly press Alt Tab, Alt Tab, Alt Tab. So what you can actually do is create something called a second desktop, which is called a virtual desktop. Now, a virtual desktop, you can basically access these from the same menu here by clicking this button here, Windows 10. And this will bring up your desktops at the bottom here. Now, as you can see, I have three desktops currently. I have my desktop one, which basically has my email, my Facebook, my Skype messages. This is sort of just my social desktop. Then if I switch over to my second desktop, here's where I have a lot of my school stuff. So this is my notes, Microsoft Word, and some other school documents. In my third desktop, I mostly have my editing stuff. Here I have Audition open, here I have OBS open, my videos folder, and Premiere Pro if I'm editing something. So a lot of times, I'll switch between different desktops if I'm not working on, say, if I'm not doing homework, if I'm not doing schooling, I'll switch over to my third desktop doing editing. If I'm not doing either of those, I usually switch over to my social desktop or have one of my games open on my first desktop here as well. And it keeps things a bit more organized. You don't have to have so many windows open if you're not using them. If you're someone like me, sometimes you may not want to close windows because you're like, well, I'm going to need it later on anyway, so why should I close the window? Well, virtual desktops make it very easy. You can keep things open and still have them running and still be organized enough so you don't have to have them in the way when you have all your windows open. You want to stay organized and you want to only have a certain amount of windows active. So it's basically another way of, so it's basically separating your already separated tabs into different desktops for extra separation. It's kind of weird how I said that, but that's basically what it is. So you can keep on adding more desktops by clicking the new desktop icon here. And so you can make as many, and as you can see, you can make as many as you want. And each of these desktops could have something else in it. You can also close desktops very easily. And if you end up closing one of these, say you close desktop 3, everything will be moved to desktop 2. And as you can see, here's what I was talking about. We have a lot of tabs open. Maybe you don't want to have all this stuff in one desktop. Well, you can easily right-click some windows, move to a new desktop. And you could do the same thing with this. Move to desktop 3. And same with these. You can move to desktop 3. And as you can see, everything is now in desktop 3 here. And you can Alt-Tab as usual. And if you want to switch desktops, you can click this button. Or if you want to switch desktops more easier, you can also press the Windows key and the Control key. And then hit the left and right arrow keys. And it will actually bring you between desktops to make it very easy. So that's the Windows key, the Control key, and left and right. Those three buttons, you can switch between desktops. It's a neat little feature if you're someone who likes to stay organized, if you usually have a lot of things open, if you have several different workspaces open. This is a really neat feature, and it's something to take advantage of. It's something I'm using more and more every day because I can have several virtual desktops open. If you've used Linux in the past or Mac, it's pretty much a similar concept. Those operating systems have this already in place, but now Windows 10 does too. Just thought I'd make a video and share it because it is pretty neat, and hopefully you'll find it helpful and useful in the future after watching this video. And that's pretty much it. That's all I wanted to share. That's everything I wanted to go over. Kind of a quick little tutorial. Just thought I'd throw it out there because it is very useful. If you liked the video, go ahead and leave it a like. Any questions or comments, leave a comment in the comment box down below. Definitely down there answering any questions you have. Talking with you guys as usual. If you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, go ahead and subscribe. Lots of other tutorials on the channel. Software tutorials on the channel. Windows tutorials. YouTube tutorials, lots of cool stuff on there. If you're interested in editing, I have editing tutorials as well. So if you're interested in that, go ahead and subscribe to the channel. Would love to have you on board. I also have a Patreon page. You want to donate $1, anything as low as that is very helpful, much appreciated. Click the card in the top right hand corner of the screen and it'll bring you to the page. And if you want to check out my vlogging channel, gaming channel, advice channel, or music channel, links in the description as well as on the end card. And that's pretty much it. Thank you for watching as always, And this is GSmaniamsmart, and I'll be back sooner than you think. Don't go anywhere.